गुड आफ्टरनून ऑल ऑफ यू। गुड
आफ्टरनून।
ओके, दिस इज आवर लास्ट टॉपिक फ्रॉम द सेकंड यूनिट। ओके, एंड अप टिल नाउ ऑल द मेन कंटेंट ऑफ द सेकंड यूनिट ऑलरेडी वी हैव स्टडीड, एंड दिस इज जस्ट द केस स्टडी on the content that we have studied up till now in case of the second unit. And today we are going to discuss the case study related with the information technology infrastructure in bank. Okay, now before we go to the actual content of the information technology infrastructure in bank, I want to ask you one question. What difference you find as a information technology versus the information system? Both are the same thing, or there are some differences in that? Yes, all of you got the question? Yes, what is the difference between the information technology and the information system? Both are the similar, or there are the some differences between them? Question samajla ka sagalyanna?
Yes sir.
Just try to give the answer. Yes. What is the information technology? What do you mean by the information technology? Yes. Speak up. Okay, you might be the wrong, right? We'll discuss on that. What do you mean by the information technology? Yes. Yes, Jadhav Mansi. What do you mean by the information technology?
Means advancement in the technology. It help to means आपल्याला ते हेल्प करतं ॲडव्हान्स म्हणजे लवकरात लवकर सर्च करण्यासाठी आपला गोल अचीव करण्यासाठी डिसिजन घेण्यासाठी गुड डिसिजन घेण्यासाठी.
वैशाली बोलणारे वैशाली.
सर वेरियस म्हणजे टेक्नॉलॉजी मीन्स डिव्हाइसेस वगैरे वर आपण जे नवीन नवीन प्रोसेस वगैरे करतो आपण नवीन काहीतरी सॉफ्टवेअर वगैरे आणतो किंवा मग ते नवीन इनोव्हेशन इन्फॉर्मेशन टेक्नॉलॉजी.
सो इन्फॉर्मेशन टेक्नॉलॉजी इज नथिंग बट द सिस्टीम. सिस्टीम इन द सेन्स व्हॉट? द कम्प्युटर्स विच आर युटिलाइज फॉर व्हॉट पर्पोज? विच आर युटिलाइज फॉर द पर्पोज ऑफ स्टोरिंग द इन्फॉर्मेशन, प्रोसेसिंग द इन्फॉर्मेशन, रिट्राइविंग द इन्फॉर्मेशन, गॅदरिंग द इन्फॉर्मेशन, or the collecting the information, etc., etc. Okay. So what is the information system then? What is the information system then? What difference you are finding between this term and this term, information technology and the information system?
Information technology is related with only devices and systems like and information
hardware,
system
like computer hardware, computer software, these kind of things we can say as a part of and the processing of data using the that computer software hardware technology. That is the information technology. Okay, but information system is not just the what we can say use of the computer hardware, computer software, etc., etc. So information system is nothing but the set of related components, and in that set of related components, information technology is one component. Yes or no? Got the point? As we have already discussed number of times, information system is what? It is a set of related component which are used for the purpose of collection of information, storage of information, processing of information, and the distribution of information. Okay, that part we have studied as the information system, correct? Now in that part, one of the component is nothing but the information technology. You are getting what that component? Computer hardware and the computer softwares are nothing but the part of our information technology. All of you agree?
Yes, sir.
But the other part, like people, various kind of procedure and the process which is being utilized in the business for the making their business making their business convenient for the all the employee, etc., etc. So apart from the information technology as a component of the information system, there are other components are also there. Understood? So we can say information system, we can say the information technology is nothing but the bridge between information system and the user of the information system. Yes or no? Can we say like this?
Yes, sir.
Because if the information technology will not available, can we able to utilize the information system? What I'm saying, if the information technology is not available, can we able to utilize the information system?
No, sir.
No. Because if you want to utilize the modern, okay, specific word I should utilize here, the modern information system. Correct. Because if you want to utilize the modern information system, there is a necessity of the computer, hardware, software, network, etc., etc. And that is the reason we can say here, the information system, the information technology is nothing but the one of the major component of information system. Understood? So in somewhere in the some book, you will also find these two terms are utilized interchangeably. What I'm saying, these two terms can be utilized interchangeably, means in place of the information system, information technology might have been utilized, or in place of the information technology, information system might be utilized. But there is a basic difference in that. Okay, yes or no? There is a basic difference in that. The basic difference is what? The information technology is nothing but the one of the component which is the part of your information system. Likewise, in the diagram I have shown. Correct? This is our main information system, and its component I have shown like the people, process, and the information technology. Now, this information technology is nothing but the computer hardware, computer software, etc., etc. Okay, got the point? Got the relation between the information technology and the information system?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So just you know, because somewhere we have utilized the yesterday also we have seen the information technology infrastructure and the choices. Okay. And today also we are discussing the information technology infrastructure in the bank. Means we are discussing one major component of the information system. Okay. So you should not get the confusion in that. Okay, we are discussing what the one major component related with the information system as a information technology infrastructure. Okay, now our today's point of discussion here is the information technology, that is we are discussing today the case study, that is the information technology infrastructure in the banking sector. Okay, now number of times we have discussed ki huge number of changes and the advancement in the IT field and the IT infrastructure have promoted the number of businesses or number of organization in India and the outside India also to make the utilization of the IT infrastructure, to make the utilization of the information technology. For what purpose? टू बिल्ड द स्ट्रॅटेजीज टू डू द प्लॅनिंग टू इम्प्रूव्ह द ऑर टू इन्क्रीज द प्रॉफिटेबिलिटी ऑफ द बिझनेस ऑर्गनायझेशन अँड प्रोव्हाइड मेनी मोर सर्व्हिसेस विच वी कॅन गिव द बेटर रिझल्ट ॲज कम्पेअर विथ द ट्रॅडिशनल बिझनेस प्रोसेस ऑर दॅज कम्पेअर विथ द ट्रॅडिशनल बिझनेस ऍक्टिव्हिटी. So because of the entry of the information technology and along with the if you want to utilize the information technology, definitely you must have what? You must have the infrastructure related with the information technology. Yes, all of you are agree? Correct. If you want to utilize the information technology in the any business, what you need? You need the infrastructure related with the information technology. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes. And like the number of businesses, manufacturing industries or the institution, educational institution nowadays utilizing the information technology and the information system. And that's why they have to invest in the that information technology infrastructure. Okay. Invest in the information technology infrastructure in the sense what? What do you mean by these? Investing in the information technology infrastructure means what? Investing in the information technology infrastructure. Suppose there is a XYZ company is there. Now they want to utilize information system, and in order to utilize the information system, main component is what? The information technology infrastructure. So they need to invest into that information technology infrastructure in the sense what? They need to purchase the resources related with the information technology. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
What are the components of information technology infrastructure? Like the computer hardware there, computer software are there, etc., etc. So that is the meaning of what? Number of companies who want to utilize the information system, and if the company utilize the information system, definitely they have to invest in the information technology infrastructure. Means they have to pay the money for that so that they can utilize that services, etc., etc. And they are getting the benefit of that in order to make the planning, in order to get the good profit, etc., in order to provide the good service to the customer, etc. In the similar way, banking sector are also started investing in the information technology and system. What I have written here, banking sector also started investing in the information technology and system means what? Banking sector also started utilizing the information system and the information technology so that they can also give the better service, good service to their customers. Understood? And because of that, nowadays you can see number of banks in our country and in other country also are growing very fastly. Their customer database is growing very fastly because of the utilization of the information system and the technology, it become possible to give the good service to the customer. Understood? Now if I ask you what are the reason for investing in the IT infrastructure, okay, what are the reasons for investing in the IT infrastructure? Reasons are nothing but the you can give the better service to the customer, means the customer convenience will increase, customer can access to the information easily and the fastly, speed of transaction will improve, okay, and because of that the customer satisfaction also get improved. So these are nothing but the various reason that nowadays banking sector also utilizing the information technology and system. Okay, understood this point?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Now what we have to discuss next, the information technology in the banking sector can be divided into the two different areas. In banking sector, information technologies are kay, where where actually the relation comes nowadays. Okay, as I said, number of banks today utilizing the information technology and the system. So there are the two major areas. Okay, there are the two major areas, the two major banking sector where the information technology are being under the utilization. Okay, and in that, first area is the electronic banking. First area is what? The electronic banking. Okay, so information technology in the banking sector divided into the two areas. One of that area is what? The electronic banking, which is being also famously referred as what? The e-banking. It is e-banking. What do you mean by the e-banking? Tell me. What do you mean by the e-banking? What is e-banking?
Means आपण आता जे ऑनलाइन पेमेंट वगैरे करतो, पैसे ट्रान्सफर वगैरे करतो.
Exactly. So e-banking is described as the act of conducting out the business transaction or the individual transaction using the electronic devices. Electronic devices in the sense there you are utilizing the mobile, computer, etc., etc. Okay, so doing the transaction with your bank using such kind of devices is referred as the electronic banking. This is the first area where the information technology being utilized. Okay, so e-banking is also, I have written in the different word, e-banking is about the using the information technology infrastructure of the digital age to create the more opportunity for the services. Using the technology infrastructure of digital age in the sense utilizing the technology infrastructure related with the computers, etc., etc. Okay, now because of this e-banking, because of the e-banking, number of benefits are getting. Now benefits are not getting to the bank only. Benefits are getting to the customer only. Okay, one of the great benefit is what? There is a drastic lowering of transaction cost. What? There is a huge decrease in the transaction cost. That is the one benefit. Another, because of that, new types of the banking opportunities or the new type of banking services are being getting performed. And very important, the barrier of time and the distance is getting solved. What? The great benefit because of the e-banking is what? The barrier of time and distance is getting solved. Now you tell me about this point. What do you mean by the barrier of time and distance gets solved because of the e-banking? Yes, what do you mean by the barrier of time and distance is get solved because of the e-banking? Means what? Barrier in the sense ki suppose ata jar information technology and infrastructure jar utilization banke madhe nasta tar tumhala physically banke madhe java lagla asta. Yes or no?
Yes sir.
There you have to waste your time and you have to travel also if the bank is not close to your home. Yes or no?
Yes sir.
That problem is getting solved because of the utilization of the information technology and the infrastructure in the bank. Yes or no? Correct.
Yes sir.
So no need to go far away. If you are paid the college fee now, you are directly paid from the mobile number of student. Correct.
Yes sir.
So there you have saved your time and the distance, and that is nothing but the great benefit of the e-banking. Okay. Now come to the next point, the example of various electronic devices being utilized to do the e-banking. Okay, like I said, the computer system, mobiles, computer system is the one device, then the GSM mobiles or smart mobiles, ATM, internet facilities, smart cards, electronic mail, point of sale, etc., etc. Point of sale bagitla ka tumhi? Point of sale means what? What do you mean by the point of sale? Point of sale as an electronic device to do the electronic banking. बँकेमध्ये ते छोटं डिवाइस असतं बघा, किंवा मग कम्प्युटर सेंटर्स मध्ये पण असतं काही डिवाइस कसतं. इफ यू तुम्ही एसटी बस मध्ये त्या कंडक्टर कडे एक छोटं डिवाइस असतं बघा, ते बघितलं असतं तुम्ही बरोबर. लाईक दॅट लाईक दॅट काइंड ऑफ डिवाइस इज यूज देअर इन केस ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रॉनिक बँकिंग, की तुम्ही तुम्ही यू कॅन इन्सर्ट युअर कार्ड इन दॅट डिवाइस अँड यू कॅन डू द ट्रान्झॅक्शन. गॉट द पॉइंट? दॅट इज कॉल्ड एज द पॉइंट ऑफ सेल इलेक्ट्रॉनिक डिवाइस. ओके, सो दीज आर द डिफरंट इलेक्ट्रॉनिक डिवाइसेस आर युटिलाइज इन द इलेक्ट्रॉनिक बँकिंग. नाउ अनदर एरिया वेअर द इन्फॉर्मेशन टेक्नॉलॉजी इन द बँकिंग सेक्टर is nothing but the e-commerce. Another area in case of the banking where the information technology being utilized is what? E-commerce. What is mean by the e-commerce? Tell me, what do you mean by the e-commerce? E-commerce is what?
ऑनलाईन बाईंग अँड सेलिंग.
ऑनलाईन बाईंग अँड सेलिंग आपण बघितलं ना फर्स्ट युनिटची केस स्टडी मध्ये. ओके, जर ई कॉमर्स तुम्हाला करायचं असेल, करेक्ट, देर इज अ रोल ऑफ द बँक, करेक्ट?
यस सर.
आणि जर बँकचा रोल असेल आणि तिथं जर बँक जर इन्फॉर्मेशन इन्फॉर्मेशन टेक्नॉलॉजी आणि सिस्टीम जर बँक युटिलाइज करत नसेल तर आपण ई कॉमर्स युज करू शकू का?
नो सर.
नो. So bank also need to provide this facility of utilization of the information technology and the system. Then and then only we can do the e-commerce. So here I have written the e-commerce is a system which includes the transaction that center that stress on or that center on the buying and selling of goods and services online directly generate the revenue. So e-commerce provide the advantage by adding the easiness, flexibility being offered to the customer through the electronic networks. Okay. As well as I have written here, the e-commerce provide the consumer the ability to do the banking, invest, purchase, distribute, communicate, explore, research from the any location at any time. That is because of the connection of the internet. Okay, if you want to utilize the e-commerce, then definitely you should have the internet connection available. So this is the another area related with the banking where the there comes the information technology role. Okay. Let's move forward. That is also related with the service being provided by the bank with the help of the information technology and system. Okay, that is what CSD, customer service delivery. Okay, CSD stands for the customer service delivery. So now customer service delivery main purpose is nothing but how the bank can save maximum amount of time of their customer. How bank can make activity of the customer more convenient and the more easy, more efficient and the more effective. Okay, now for that purpose, now in case of the CSD, related with the CSD, the bank now introducing and number of banks are now having the welcome kits. Have you seen the how many of you are having the bank accounts in the nationalized bank? Most of you are having the bank accounts in the nationalized bank, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Is there anybody who are utilizing the net banking kind of services? Net banking aahe kunacha? Nobody have? Okay,
no,
now
sir.
If you now you have just opened the account, okay, as you are now student, but if you just go to the bank and if you say them, I want to open the account and I want all the services to be get enabled, then that bank provide you the one welcome kit. Welcome kit manje kay asta ki ek envelope madhe te tumcha ID, password, your information, tumcha debit card, checkbook, ya sagya goshti tya welcome kit madhe dile jatat. Understood, as within one envelope. So bank have introduced that welcome kit. Okay, and a customer using that welcome kit, customer can open the account with the bank, okay, and can enable the account of himself, okay, through the internet, and he can get the checkbook by using the net banking request. He can do the net banking where he can transfer the money using the computer, computer, internet. No need to go to the bank physically. He can do the phone banking through using the phone. He can send the money and he can receive the money, etc., etc. So all these services can be get enabled if you open the account and you receive the welcome kit from that bank. So that welcome kit contains your net banking ID, password, etc., etc. Okay. So nowadays, the number of banks you can see, time requirement for the opening account is very less. Okay. If you compare the period before the 10 years, more than 1 week, 2 weeks amount of time were required to open the account. But if you see today, within a 1 day or 2 day, your account is getting open. Correct. Now, this all these things because of what? Because of the integration of this information technology and infrastructure in the banking sector, and through that the banking provide you the this kind of service, that is the customer service delivery. Okay. And because of these, it leads to the customer convenience. Customer are having the easiness in doing the banking. Okay, as well as bank cost can also be getting saved. And bank can easily identify the need of the customers, and accordingly bank can provide the services to the customer according to the need of the customer. Okay. So because of this point, customer service delivery, what are the requirements of the customer? Suppose customer want to open the account, through this welcome kit, account opening has become very easy. Using that details given in the welcome kit, customer can himself through the internet can open his net banking account and he can enjoy the services. Okay. And because of this, all these things, there is an increase in the competitive advantage of the particular banks. If the banks give the good service through the utilization of the information technology and system, definitely the customer will get attracted to that bank. Okay. And also the customer faith will increase on that bank. Customer reliability will increase on that bank if that bank provide the good service to that particular customer. So all these things become possible because of the customer service delivery facility, and customer service delivery facility can be become available only because of the utilization of this information technology and system. Okay. Now come to our main point here, that is the information technology infrastructure in the bank. If the bank want to utilize the information technology and the system, what kind of the IT infrastructure is going to be required for them? Okay. Yesterday also one point we have discussed the IT infrastructure and the choices, general point we have discussed. Now here specifically related with the bank, what kind of IT infrastructure can be required for the bank? Now, what is the IT infrastructure? IT infrastructure is nothing but the different kind of physical devices and the services, management related support, computing resources in an organization for the purpose of performing the various kind of operation, documentation, integration, maintenance, etc., etc. That part yesterday we have discussed. But now point here we have to understand is what? What are the IT infrastructure related with the bank specifically? Now, here I have mentioned following are the resources are included in the IT infrastructure of the bank. Okay. What are that? Computer hardware and the computer software, network and the communication technology, data, various kind of processing application required for the banking. So these are the four main resources included in the IT infrastructure of the bank. Okay, which resources? First is what? Computer hardware software. Then if that bank is having the branches in the multiple location, will there be the need of network? Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes. If bank is having the location in the now you are utilizing the ATM of the particular bank from anywhere, yes or no? From any location.
Yes, sir.
How this become possible? Because of the network and the communication technology utilized within a bank. Okay. Another resource is nothing but the data related with the customers, etc., etc. And to process the information related with the customer, we need the bank also needs some kind of processing applications. You can say here the processing application has a different kind of software utilized by the bank for the banking purpose. Okay. So this is the main resource included in the IT infrastructure in the bank. Okay. Now let's move next. So this IT infrastructure has provided the capability to the bank so that they can get the competitive advantage. What do you mean by the competitive advantage to the bank? Suppose there is one bank A is there and bank D is there. Okay. Understand the situation. Bank A is there and the bank D is there. Bank A is having the utilization of the IT infrastructure and the system for their banking purpose, but the bank D is not having. Where you open the account, in the bank A or in the bank B? Yes, do you understand the question what I am asking, or shall I repeat? Yes.
Bank A.
Because bank A is having the utilization of the information technology and system, so that bank A can provide the more service as compared with the bank D. Understood. And that's why the bank A will get the more customer. So that is the meaning of this point. Bank A will have the more competitive advantage on the bank D. So strong IT infrastructure enable the employees of that bank to perform their respective job easily. So utilization of the IT infrastructure and the system not only help to the customer, it also help to their employees also. Okay. So both from having the available technology and the necessary technological skills. So that employee must have the skill to utilize that IT infrastructure. In the sense that if employee want to utilize the information technology and system, he must have the knowledge of how to utilize the computer, etc., etc. So there is a direct relationship between the IT, the particular IT firm and the performance of that particular bank. If the bank utilizing the information technology system, etc., etc., then the performance of that bank can be easily grow as compared with the other banks who are not utilizing that. But nowadays you can see number of banks are, every bank is having the utilization of this kind of things, information technology and system. So in other words, we can say here that IT infrastructure capabilities enable the particular firms or the organization or the bank to position their IT asset to capture the information about the customer as well as distribute the information to the customer in order to create the satisfaction. So because of utilization of this IT infrastructure and the system, customer information can be get filled easily, can be get captured easily, as well as if the bank want to send some information to the customer, that information is also get sent to the customer easily through the mail or through the messages. If you withdraw the amount from the bank, at that point only you will get the message from the bank that your account has been debited or the credited. Correct? Yes or no? You are getting the message or not? Correct? Yes or no?
Yes.
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 Also, and if you have email account attached with that bank, you can get the email also. Why this has become all possible? Because of the information technology infrastructure and system being utilized in the banking sector. Okay. Now let's see there are the two categorization related to the information technology infrastructure in the bank. There are the two main components. Okay. From the whatever the discussion we have done up till now, from that the IT infrastructure is composed of the two components. Okay. In that, first is technical information technology infrastructure, And second dividation of the infrastructure is what? Human information technology infrastructure. Okay. First, IT infrastructure composed of what? Technical information technology infrastructure. आता टेक्निकल इन्फॉर्मेशन टेक्नॉलॉजी इन्फ्रास्ट्रक्चर मध्ये काय येतं? हियर आय हॅव रिटन द टेक्निकल आस्पेक्ट ऑफ द आयटी इन्फ्रास्ट्रक्चर. टेक्निकल आस्पेक्ट ऑफ द आयटी इन्फ्रास्ट्रक्चर इन द सेन्स वेरियस काइंड ऑफ डिव्हाइसेस दॅट यू युटिलाइज, दॅट इज द टेक्नॉलॉजी. ओके, वेरियस काइंड ऑफ सॉफ्टवेअर, हार्डवेअर एटसेट्रा एटसेट्रा दॅट यू युटिलाइज, ऍप्लिकेशन अँड द डेटा. So in the technical aspect of the IT infrastructure, three components are there. Three main factors are there. First is what? Applications. Application in the sense what? Various softwares, etc., etc. Correct? Second component, data. And third is the technology being get utilized. Understood? So first categorization of the IT infrastructure is what? Technical information technology infrastructure. त्याच्यामध्ये काय येतं? ऍप्लिकेशन, डेटा अँड द टेक्नॉलॉजी इज बिंग युटिलाइज बाय दॅट पर्टिक्युलर बँक. नाव इन द टेक्नॉलॉजी इन द सेन्स वॉट कॅन यू टेल मी, वॉट डू मीन द टेक्नॉलॉजी इन द टेक्निकल आस्पेक्ट ऑफ द आयटी इन्फ्रास्ट्रक्चर? आय टोल्ड यू ऍप्लिकेशन आर नथिंग बट द सॉफ्टवेअर एटसेट्रा एटसेट्रा, डेटा डेटा ऑफ द कस्टमर एटसेट्रा, अँड टेक्नॉलॉजी. वॉट इज दिस कंपोनंट टेक्नॉलॉजी? Yes. If some bank is utilizing the cloud-based services, okay, listen carefully. If some bank is utilizing the cloud-based services, that cloud-based service is nothing but the one technology. Yes or no? Got the point?
Yes, sir.
So these three things comes under the technical information technology infrastructure. Okay. And second component is, understood the first component?
Yes.
That is what? Technical information technology infrastructure, which consists of the three factor: applications, then the data, and the kind of technology being utilized by the bank. Okay. Then we have the second component in the IT infrastructure related with the bank, that is the human information technology infrastructure. That is what? Now you tell me. Second in the IT infrastructure, that is second component is what? Human information technology infrastructure. So human aspect, here I have written, human aspect of the IT infrastructure consists of the what? Peoples. People in the sense what? The employee who are working there, as well as the customers. Yes or no?
Yes.
So that comes under the which infrastructure? Human information technology infrastructure, as well as knowledge, that particular knowledge acquired by that particular employee or the customer related with the utilization of these services, knowledge and the capability required to handle the organizational information technology resources. Okay, so the knowledge required for that people, in the sense knowledge required by that customer or the employee to handle this services provided by the bank through the information technology and the system. So employee and the customer must have the knowledge of how to handle the computer, mobile, how to send the money, receive the money, etc., etc. That kind of everything comes under the another infrastructure, that is the human information technology infrastructure, mainly consists of the people and the knowledge and the capability required by that particular people, in the sense required by that employee or the customer, how to handle this technology utilized by the bank. Understood the second component?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now let's last point of this topic, that is the various challenges resolved by the information technology and system in the banking. What? Various challenges resolved by the information technology and system in the bank. Now you tell me, what do you mean by this? Various challenges resolved by the information technology and system in the banking.
Sir,
चैलेंजेस इन द सेंस व्हाट रिजोल्यूशन ऑफ द चैलेंज और चैलेंजेस
जे प्रॉब्लम्स असतात ते फेस करणे
जे अगोदर काय प्रॉब्लेम होते दैट प्रॉब्लेम बीइंग सॉल्व बाय द इन्फॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी एंड सिस्टम तर ते सम ऑफ द चैलेंजेस आई हैव मेंशन हियर द फर्स्ट इंपॉर्टेंट चैलेंज वॉज व्हाट रिलेटेड विद द अकाउंट ओपनिंग प्रोसेस दैट ऑल्सो वी हैव डिस्कस व्हाट की ट्रेडिशनल कन्सिडर करा की बैंकिंग आपल्याला काय सध्या इन्फॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी एंड सिस्टम अवेलेबल नाही असं कन्सिडर करा तर अकाउंट ओपनिंग प्रोसेस साठी कमी वेळ लागेल का जास्त वेळ लागेल इफ द इन्फॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी अँड सिस्टम इज नॉट युटिलाइज बाय द बँक देन द टाइम रिक्वायर्ड फॉर द अकाउंट ओपनिंग विल बी लेस और मोर
मोर
मोर टाइम विल रिक्वायर बिकॉज दॅट इन्फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द कस्टमर हॅज टू बी शेअर विथ द मेन ब्रांच एटसेट्रा एटसेट्रा देर आर द नंबर ऑफ प्रोसेस इन्वॉल्व देर सो दॅट ट्रॅडिशनल प्रोसेस वॉज व्हेरी कंबरसम इन द सेन्स ट्रॅडिशनल प्रोसेस वॉज व्हेरी डिफिकल्ट time consuming requiring the filling of various kind of forms submission of the different kind of documents etc so this was the traditional method of opening the bank these are all the requirements okay but nowadays you can see this process has been simplified very what you can say at a very good manner yes or no this process has simplified because you have to just the bank has provided bank is providing the service if you want to open the account okay so bank is utilizing the your Aadhaar card details yes or no
yes sir
and using that the you can see the bank linked the account opening to the Aadhaar card and because of this all the information containing that related with your Aadhaar card automatically get transferred to the account opening form and within a one day or a two day your bank account is getting open okay so because of the entry of this information technology and system the first challenge being easily solved is nothing but the related to the account opening process understood then another thing is the banking experience for the customer has been improved okay what banking experience has improved because of the entry of the information technology and system banking experience has improved related with the status of customer account means customer can check using the mobile how much amount is there in his account or not how much amount is there in his bank account yes or no using mobile you can check it or not
yes sir
using computer yes. you can check it or not
Yes, sir.
Now
yes,
there are the different applications are available like phone pay google pay etc why how this become possible because the bank has become integrated with this information technology and system so customer can get the loan assistance for their needs within a very much less amount of time he can know about the rate of interest on the loan he can get the fast transaction execution etc okay so that is the another thing the banking experience of the customer that challenge is easily solved because of the entry of the information system and the technology in the banking sector okay another very important challenge that is solved and for that challenge was for the bank itself because now consider there is a no information technology and system utilized in the bank then how it will become possible how the particular bank will share their information of one branch with the another branch suppose the SBI branch is there in the Yewla and SBI branch want to share their information to the branch which is available in the Nashik and consider there is a no information technology and system what will happen you tell me
more time
will required okay there will be the requirement of the more manpower understood now but because of the integration of this because of the entry of this information technology system in the banking sector as we have discussed there, one of the resource of infrastructure is nothing but the communication and the network. And because of that, what happened? All the branches of the bank has been get integrated under the one umbrella. Means all the bank branches are get connected through the networks. And because of that, there is a very, very, what we can say, there is a easiness in the communication of the employee of the bank, as well as if the one bank branch want to transfer the documents of the customer to the other bank branch, because of this network of banking branches, it has become very easy and it has become very faster. Understood. So that is another issue being resolved by the entry of this information technology and system in the banking sector. Okay. And if all these things has to be get resolved, then there is a huge role being performed by these two IT infrastructure, that is nothing but the technical information technology infrastructure and the human resource technology infrastructure, which in short you can also refer the which we can refer here also the resources being there in the IT infrastructure like this. Now this resource, आता हे जे resources मी इथे दाखवलेत तेच फक्त खाली divide केलेत. You are getting what I'm saying? हे जे चार resources आहेत तेच मी खाली फक्त काय केलेत, divide केलेत याच्यामध्ये. Yes or no? Okay, that four resources that there I have shown you, that only some resources are being part of this infrastructure and some resources are being part of this infrastructure. Correct? Okay, understood this point?
Yes, sir.
Like you can see there, as we have broadly divided the IT infrastructure in the two part, like technical information and the human information technology. So here the same thing you can divide in, you can divide these four resources in that two categories also, like technical information technology infrastructure, nothing but these kind of things like computer hardware, software, then the network communication technology, okay, processing and application and data. This is everything is related with the, what you can say, the first component, that is the technical information technology infrastructure. And second component is what? Our human information technology infrastructure. So in under the human information technology infrastructure, which things comes? People and the knowledge acquired by that people to handle that information technology and system. Okay, understood? Yes, any doubt in these points?
No, sir.
Okay. So what we have discussed under the these case studies, we have discussed the different things like what is exactly mean by the IT infrastructure in the banking, then in which sector in the banking these IT infrastructure are being utilized, like electronic banking in the as well as in the electronic commerce, that is the e-commerce, there is a huge role of IT and the system information technology and system. Then we have discussed how the information technology and system help to provide the customer service delivery through the welcome kits, its benefits. And then we have divided the IT infrastructure in the bank in the two main categories here. Okay, and then lastly we have discussed the challenges that is being solved by the information technology and system in the banking. Okay, I hope all of you have got this point. Yes?
Yes, sir.
Okay, here we have finished our second unit. Okay, that was the management information system and the number of points we have discussed in the second unit. Okay. And in case of your NSEM, we have the third unit. Okay, that will start in the next week. Okay. So if you have any doubt in the contents related with the second unit, you can comment in the comment section. Okay. Now your homework is what? Once again, you should go through the all the videos, okay, that we have discussed in case of the second unit. Okay. So shall we conclude now here?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Thank you, all of you.
Thank you, sir.